Hello, welcome. This is Stu Siegel, and we're doing the next lesson in How to Read Drum Music by Stu Siegel and Jimmy Sika. What you need to do this lesson is a practice pad, pair of sticks, and the book, How to Read Drum Music. You can find the book by Stu Siegel and Jimmy Sika on Amazon.com. What we're doing today is example 8, eighth note triplets. This is where I think it starts to be fun. Eighth note triplets are a little different than what we've done in the past. Actually, triplets are different. I'm sure you've read the text of the book. Triplets are what they sound like. They're threes. They're groups of threes. They'll always be represented by a little three over top, no matter what size triplets they are. These happen to be eighth note triplets. And why are they called eighth note triplets? An eighth note triplet takes up the same space as two eighth notes, as you'll see when we play this. If these were quarter note triplets, then a quarter note triplet would take up the space of two quarter notes. But these are eighth note triplets. An eighth note triplet takes up the same space as two eighth notes. And those three strokes need to be played evenly spaced in that space of the eighth note triplet. Well, how do we count these? We can't count them the same. Even though they fit in that space, they're not a division of four like everything else we've done in the past. Whole notes, half notes, quarter notes, sixteenth notes, all somehow can be divided up into four. Well, these are threes. So how we do this is we count them a little differently. We know we count eighth notes, one and two and three and four and. We count sixteenth notes, one eanda, two eanda, three eanda, four eanda. Well, eighth note triplets, we're going to count one and two and three and four and. But we'll count them in the same space with the same timing as we would be counting eighth notes. Remember, this is 4-4 time, so there are four quarter notes or the equivalent thereof in every measure. Well, an eighth note triplet is equivalent to a quarter note. So the one, the two, the three, the four happen at the same time. So let's play the first line and you'll see. In the first measure, we have eighth notes. In the second measure, we have eighth note triplets. Okay, let's play the first line. One, two, ready, play. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Okay. So, in the first measure we have one and two and. In the second measure we have one and two and. But the one, the two, spaced the same. Let's go on to the next line where we have some, eighth note triplets set between quarter notes. One, two, ready, play. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Okay. You getting the idea here? Let's do the next line, which has eighth notes, quarter notes, and some triplets. One, two, ready, play. One, and two, and three, and four, and one, two, and three, and four, and okay, now let's go on to the next line where it gets a little more interesting because we have some other figures that are three notes thrown in. In the first figure, we have, after the two, we have E and A. Well, that's three notes played close together. They don't take up the same space as a quarter note, though, because you're not playing the two. And on the four, we have four E and. We're not playing the duh. So the 4EN is not the same as 4NDA, as you'll see when you play it, because in the second measure, we're going to have those interspersed between the triplets. Okay, so we are now on measure 7, the fourth line down. Okay, ready? Let's play this. But this will count as 16th notes, since the smallest note on the line is a 16th. Okay, here we go. One, two, ready, play. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2 and a 3E and a 4 and a. Okay, so I suppose by now you've noticed the way we are switching the count up and back. We are basically counting either an 8th or a 16th note count, and where necessary, we're putting in the 8th note triplet count. So the second measure, we would count as 1E and a 2 and a 3E and a 4 and a. 1E and a 2 and a 3E and a 4 and a. You just have to switch that counting over in your mind when you see the triplet. Okay, let's play the last line. One, two, ready, play. 1E and a 2E and a 3 and a 4E and a 1 and a 2E and a 3 and a 4. Okay, so you got the idea. An eighth note triplet goes in the same space as two eighth notes, and it's three notes evenly spaced across that space. One and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, three and a, four and a, one and a, two and a, three and a, four and a, which is different than one and two and three and four. Okay, that's eighth note triplets. Jimmy and I thank you for learning to read from our book, How to Read Drum Music, and we'll see you in the next lesson.